Hi there. In this video, I want to do a quick introduction into Phoenix. Now, I'm a Rails developer, so I was super excited to open up Phoenix and give it a bit of a try. There's a lot of ideas that you can take from Rails and apply to Phoenix, so I want to share what those parallels are and why I felt so at home with Phoenix. Now, I know they're two fundamentally different frameworks, but even so, there's a lot of things that you can kind of take from Rails and help you get kind of productive with Phoenix. So let's just dive into it. What is Phoenix? Phoenix is a full-stack web framework written in Elixir, and it's built around the model view controller architecture. So there's a lot of similarities that you can draw from Rails, and definitely going to make a lot of parallels between the two frameworks. Coming from a Rails project, what I would really love to know in Phoenix is where the model views controllers live, and then also how routes are defined and where migrations exist as well. Because all of these things are, you know, what we use all the time in Rails. Before we dive into the folder structure, I want to quickly go over the application we'll be demoing. So we have a pretty basic Phoenix application that's been scaffolded using the Phoenix generators. There's only a post model, and that post model will have your CRUD actions, so the create, read, update, delete. Doesn't really do anything too fancy right now, and you know, in this video we probably won't go into making things fancy, but let's just kind of see how everything works under the hood. Let's first look at the views and controllers in a Phoenix project. Now, this is a little bit different than Rails because you notice that while we do have the controller and views folder, we also have other things called templates. If we open up the template related to our post page or post index page, you can see that's where all the HTML lives. So this is an EEX file, so that's embedded Elixir, very similar to embedded Ruby. And our views folder actually contains view functions that we can pull into our template file. And like Rails, Phoenix prefers convention over configuration. So if you notice, if we open up the controller folder, we can see our post controller matches the template's post folder and then also the post view. So all of these files are linked because of that naming structure. Controllers in Phoenix are pretty similar to controllers in Rails. All of these functions that you see are actually linked to the specific routes. So if we went to slash post, we would be calling the def index function in the Phoenix controller. Speaking of routes or routes, however you want to say it, you can find those declarations under the Hello World web directory as well. And that's found in the router.ex file. The router file in Phoenix is a little bit different than the routes file in Rails. Contains a bit more information. For example, you see these things called plugs. But for right now, what we care about is this scope block, which contains the call to all our routes. And you notice that we can just use resources, so resourceful routes like you would in Rails. The next thing that we want to look at is models and how are they defined in Phoenix. So under lib/hello-world, this is where all our models live. Now, we also have this extra kind of concept that Phoenix has and Rails doesn't, and that's called contexts. Contexts are a way to model application boundaries. They hide the internals of how a model works, and they expose a public API to other contexts to talk to. You can use contexts in Phoenix to immediately see what your project does by looking at the directory folder structure, as opposed to Rails, where you might have a bunch of model files and you don't really know the connections between the models until you go in and look at each individual file. Opening up one of these context files, all it really does is calls the model underneath it. So we can see that we list out the posts using the context, and any controller method will actually call through the context to get the posts. This means for any kind of specific model function, we can get away from this fat model concept and push everything into the context instead. And then with a model, we have this idea of change sets. This is where you could do your validations on a model. So for example, you could validate a presence of a field. So you know, this particular title needs to exist. And then using cast, you can filter out any unwanted attributes that come in from a parameter hash or a map in Elixir. And this idea is a little bit different than model.new. You can do a bit of kind of upfront processing with the change set and do this stuff before actually hitting the database. And like active record in Rails, Phoenix also uses an ORM called Ecto. With Ecto, we can make a lot of calls like we would in Rails, like you can do a .all, or insert or an update. A lot of these methods are actually found in the context file in Phoenix. So in blog.ex, that's where we would find a lot of these Ecto calls. Now, I don't want to dive too much into this because I want to show you one final thing, and that's where migrations live. So under priv/repo folder, we can see that there's also a migrations folder, and we have a create post migrations already set up because this was generated from the scaffold. And opening this file up, a lot of it feels like Rails. There's the same concept as Rails where we use def change to specify the migration. We can see that there's a create table. You can add in your columns and the types. And again, a lot of these feel like active record, and it's all powered by Ecto under the hood. Hopefully this gave you a good introduction into Phoenix. Now, I know there's a bunch of stuff that I didn't cover in this video, such as live view, and that's something that I want to dive into for future videos. But if you're a Rails developer and you're just kind of exploring this framework, I'm hoping that my ideas and these kind of parallels you can make between the two frameworks has helped kind of pique your interest. So if you want to stay tuned for upcoming videos, please hit that subscribe button. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Okay, bye.